One conflict that will probably never end is the battle of the thermostat in a space shared by men and women. Men are always turning it down, and women are two steps behind them, turning it right back up again. Despite theories to the contrary, women are not just being weak or wasteful. There are scientific reasons why they often find themselves feeling much chillier than the men in the same room. Here's the real reason why women are always colder than men.
Can I turn the heat up?
Oh, don't touch the thermostat, Meg. Your father gets upset.
Come on, this thing goes up to 90.
We'll touch the thermostat.
Colder extremities. Women's icy cold hands and feet are a long-running joke between married couples at bedtime, but there's science to back up that phenomenon. In 1998, researchers at the University of Utah found that though women's core body temperatures were higher on average, their hands were consistently colder. And it wasn't a subtle change. The study found women's hands to be about 3 degrees cooler than men's. The reason? Women's bodies are better at pulling heat back to their organs to conserve it during cold conditions. When that happens, though, their hands and feet pay the price for keeping essential organs at a warmer running temp. This explains why, when walking through a cold office, you'll see many more women than men rubbing their hands together to get warm. Metabolism. Men naturally have higher metabolic rates than women, a fact that has been annoying women for ages. According to a study in the Journal of Applied Psychology, the metabolism of most men runs about 23% higher than women's. This not only means men have an easier time burning fat, it also means they have warmer bodies. Metabolism is the way our bodies burn calories for fuel, and in the process, heats our bodies. Since women's bodies are burning less fuel, it makes sense that they'd be the chillier of the species. Fat-to-muscle ratio. The way our bodies are composed also has a lot to do with how warm we feel. In general, men have more muscle and less fat than women. Since muscle is better at generating heat, this gives men an advantage when it comes to keeping warm in cool temps. An article in Popular Science found that while fat does conserve heat, it traps it at the core, below the skin. Wait, what? What this means is that the minute your skin cools down, you'll cool down, even if your core is still warm. Add it to the long list of reasons to get your butt in the gym and pump some iron. Smaller size. Body size also has a lot to do with how cold a person feels. On average, men are larger than women, both in height and weight. Brad Firo, faculty member at Pima Community College, has an entire lesson plan explaining how size matters in regulating body temperature. According to his lesson, since women tend to be smaller, they usually have a larger surface area to volume ratio. This means that more heat is lost at a faster speed through their larger surface area. In relation, that smaller volume means less retained heat. Menstruation. Women's body temperatures tend to fluctuate throughout their menstrual cycles due to rising and falling hormone levels. This means depending on what time of the month it is, they may be even more affected by cool temperatures than normal. The situation is exacerbated even more when women take birth control. One 2001 study published in PubMed.gov found that women who took oral contraceptives had raised body temperatures during some parts of their cycles, making for an intense and chilly dip when it went back down. Different perceptions. Another explanation for women being colder than men is that women feel the cold differently than men do. According to professors David W. Neisel and Norbert K. Herzog of Medical Discovery News, when women feel cold, they constrict blood vessels near the skin surface to retain core body heat, but it makes them feel colder. Basically, our bodies have a totally different physical reaction to the very same temperatures. Weird, because men and women typically react exactly the same in most situations. Just kidding. Office temps and attire. Women who spend their days in office buildings tend to find themselves in a rough spot when it comes to dressing for the weather. A 2015 study published in Nature Climate Change finally proved what women have known all along. Office temperatures are designed for the comfort of a man. The study found that most office buildings set their thermostats according to outdated formulas, based on the metabolic rates of men. This might have made sense decades ago when most offices were predominantly male, but it's much less acceptable today when the number of women equal if not surpass the number of men. The study also revealed that the long-standing thermal comfort model employed by offices everywhere takes into consideration another factor, clothing insulation levels. Men wear suits and suits can make them hot. Pair the chilly office temps with women's regular office attire of dresses, skirts, and thin blouses, and you'll begin to understand what all the shivering is about, and why so many women have heaters under their desks, gloves and scarves stashed in their drawers, and a heavy cardigan thrown over their chairs. And this isn't just true in the winter. In the summer months, the air conditioning usually gets cranked up to near-freezing levels, blowing theories of energy conservation right out the window. Suddenly, wearing a suit jacket every day doesn't sound like such a bad idea, does it? Thanks for watching. Click the list icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out this other cool stuff we know you'll love, too.